I'm Welcome to Chattahoochee Band's winter concert. I'm Stacy Bailey, the president of the Chattahoochee Band Booster Club. It is our mission as the executive board to make every student and parent feel welcome and included. Tonight is a little different as we are live streaming the event in addition to hosting a live audience, our first time undertaking this type of event. In the future, we will be sending you some more communications for upcoming events and volunteer opportunities. Please remember, we can't do any of this without your help. If you ever need to reach out to us as an executive board, please contact us through the ChattahoocheeBand.com website. If you would, please silence all your cell phones for the duration of the performance so you may enjoy the music uninterrupted. I hope you're ready for some fun music tonight. Let's get it started with a little Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy.
Before we get going with the next group, I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about the concert. It's a little different, obviously. Usually in December, we have like 200 people on stage. We have multiple stages. We have this big sleigh ride thing. So we try to say, well, the jazz band's been working, the clarinet, the trumpet group, sax quartet, we have percussion ensemble. So some of these students are coming after school, in some cases before school. Small chamber groups and small ensembles are really the key to success in a larger group, right? So imagine anything else in the world, the sports team, where you have the whole all-star team, you know, every all-star member or whatever. But we won't go too far into the sports world. When every individual musician is stronger, it definitely makes the group. So the motto this year for me and Mr. Chrisman and the entire directors has been, okay, what can we do? And this is what we can do. So I say, hey, let's do it. I appreciate your support greatly. Because of the decisions that this community is making, we're able to do this. And you don't understand that this isn't not just a job for me. This is what I've done my whole life. I've gone to school to go to school. I played piano when I was in fourth grade, and I've never stopped doing music. So just like all of us, everybody's world kind of came to a stop. So tonight was my first night running around and managing a concert. It's kind of weird. It's kind of surreal. But I'm very proud of these students. We have a jazz band, a clarinet choir, percussion ensemble, a sax quartet. We are doing band in class, and there are students at home and there are students in person. So I really need to verbally express my thanks to you. You've allowed me to continue to do my job and my career and my passion, as well as Mr. Chrisman and all the other directors. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much. And here, I think it's the clarinet part, in a sense, right? Yeah, cool. Give it up for the clarinet part. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. everyone for coming out tonight. My name is Matt Crispin. I'm the Associate Director of Bands here. Let's give it up one more time for all the groups that have already played. They are fantastic. Some of the groups you've already heard and some more that you're going to see later is that they are entirely student-led. So the clarinet, choir, and quintet over here. Madison, stand up. She's been organizing a whole lot of that for several years now. So well done, Madison. And then down here in saxophone, we've got Joey. Go ahead and stand up, sir. It's really edifying as an educator and as a person to see young people taking on responsibilities like this for themselves. The way it shapes up a lot of the time is someone will come to us and say, hey, we would like to do a saxophone quartet. We would like to have a brass ensemble. We'd like to do all these different things. And usually they're only just asking for permission and we have no problem with that. We say, yes, absolutely do it. Sometimes it also works like we'll open a door and be like, oh, there's a clarinet choir this year. Just let it happen. So we love to see things like that. So there are a lot more student groups that are in the works. We have a trombone quartet going on. We have a low brass ensemble that's interested in happening. And it really is a fantastic thing to see young people making music in small groups for themselves instead of one person sitting up here holding a stick and yelling vehemently. It's fun to do, but, you know. So I'm going to introduce the next group before that's about to play on stage. And before I do that even, I'm going to introduce Robert Dickens, wherever he is, our director of percussion. See, you back here? There he is. Robert Dickens, thank you. Let's talk a little bit about Robert before we get to the percussion land. Robert is a degree musician who also runs his own business and teaches privately, and he's also our director of the percussion program here, which is massive and extensive, and it makes me so happy every time I see them on the field, doing drums in the gym, playing percussion ensembles. And then he's also in that office that they've got set up, teaching other students in different locations and our students in lessons. And he is just a very busy Renaissance man of all things that involve hitting something. So it's really fantastic. So I'm gonna let him introduce this percussion ensemble to everyone and talk about them for a little bit, and then we'll be off to the races. Thank you guys.
Awesome. So glad to be here tonight in the midst of all these things. Music is just such a great thing for us to all have as teachers, as well as students, because it's just a really great place to be in. And I'm glad that I have the opportunity to continue to work with your students in the midst of everything that we're going on to give us, you know, just a sense of normalcy, such as it is during this time. So the first thing that we're going to play for you guys is Ukrainian Bell Carol. And after that, we'll have Nimrod, and then we'll close with Feliz Navidad. Thank you.
Hey guys, Chrisman again on stage. So we're going to do a quick transition here as we get some members out of these other various ensembles and setting up our jazz band. A little bit about the jazz band as they're getting ready on stage. This is an ensemble consisting of literally anyone in the band who wants to show up. We are very, very, very happy and lucky to have down at the middle school Mr. Brandon Soloff and Angela Reynolds. Brandon, I'm pointing at him right now because he's actually doing sound engineering and live broadcasting for us tonight. Thank you, Brandon. In addition to thank everything that goes on at Taylor Road, the Taylor Road Jazz Band is also a fantastic ensemble. They were on stage here last week, Brandon, recording for a submission. Be on the lookout for things we hear about that. But we are really fantastically lucky. Another component in our very awesome Chattahoochee Jazz setup is one Fred Chang, who's getting his act together on stage right now. A little bit about Mr. Chang. Was the director of bands at Chattahoochee High School from one year that I'm not allowed to say to another year that I'm not allowed to say. Actually, Nick Garofalo got his start under him, and he still comes back, and he's still an active educator in Forsyth County, but he comes back and does our jazz band because he's really good at it. In addition to that, we have a number of very talented soloists on stage. You're going to wear the hat for jazz band? Okay. I keep seeing it. So I'm not going to keep delaying a whole lot longer. It looks like they're about ready to go here. I'll let percussion friends find some chairs. And we're going to start off with a tune called Coconut Champagne featuring Nick Garofalo on drum set. Here we go, everybody. Thank you. Thank you.
Kristen June, and Jesus, our guest artist on the piccolo. So we'd like to slow down a little bit, play an old Neil Hefti tune named Little Darlin'. We'll have Drew Vanon starting off on piano, and Noah Newsom again.
Thank you.
so when we're planning for this, Nick didn't tell me we're going to play for Christmas. So, sorry. We're going to play, we're a little bit out of order from what the program says. We're going to move on to another song, slower, called Samantha. We'll be featuring Thomas J.P. Marr on tenor sax. So here's Samantha. Last song, we'd like to bring out, again, Murphy Prescott's going to come in.
Enjoy your seat. We're also going to throw a little piano with Drew again and Noah Popo. This will be two views.
Thank you.
So I hope you guys had a good night tonight. I hope it was a nice change of pace. A nice change of pace, huh? Oh my gosh. It's like, there's a downtown North Cross, and my wife and I met up with Brandon Soloff. We were walking around, and Joe Branson was playing, and he was outside. It was a little bit cool out. It's actually not too bad. And it was like, whoa, live music. And we just kind of stood there, and everybody was being really cool about it. It's literally been a year since we've stood here and done this. So it's super cool. I want to tell you something. We're standing in a new room. If you might not have noticed, all these seats are brand new. The carpet's brand new. They even painted the floor right there. If you look up, you see all these lights right here are brand new. Then there's a whole new set of curtains. All those sound shells are brand new. There is four more sets of lights back there and work lights. Why are you saying, well, you have all this new stuff. Why do you have lamps over here? Right? So here's what happened. We haven't been trained on what buttons to push, so nothing's programmed. It's ridiculous. Like, dude, tell me, come on, you gotta be kidding me right now. I got like my office lamps over here. But, you know, hey, whatever, it kind of gives a lounge vibe. They painted the whole area. There's a complete new sound system. What else we got in here? I don't know, like all kinds of wires running. It's a couple million dollars, man. This has not been touched since 1991. So we're the second group to have a performance in here. So welcome to the new space. It's pretty nice. And, absolutely. It's like all these lights are LED, so this temperature on the stage has not gone up at all. So when they're out of tune, it's their fault. I can't blame it on the stage lights, you know what I mean? So, yeah. But hey, more importantly, give it up for everybody on this stage. We're the smartest person in the room, so if you are, you need to leave that room. So we're going to do it here without Fred Chang on jazz. My horrible introduction, Fred. Chris and Robert Dickens. Mackenzie Newell's not with us tonight, and so we have a bunch of other instructors as well. If I missed you, I apologize. When you leave tonight, we can't all hang out in the auditorium. There's no food anyway, so go get your curbside to go to your house. And for all you folks at home, with the live streaming, I want to thank Brandon Soloff for coming up here and doing that. We know, we have as much technology as we have at our hands, but Mr. Soloff, Mrs. Reynolds, we've got a nice commitment here, our community, or linkage, I can't talk. A nice connection. Thank you, connection. Who was that? Yeah, you can wear your hat tonight. We got a nice connection with the middle school and high school. It's a really seamless process. Anyways, I'm blabbing because I've been on stage in a year. You guys have a good night. Thanks.